Ready? Okay, and go.
Here, my man, Mike Massenzio at the Joe Palooka booth. Mike, congratulations on your UFC victory at 185. That's your weight. I know. Was this the most important fight for you?
Yeah, no, definitely for sure. You know, it was a great win. You know, last week, you know, former WBC champion Steve Cantwell. A lot of people put it past me that I wasn't going to be able to pull it out. But you know what? Just fought hard, kept coming forward, and, you know, it was my day.
New Jersey guys seem to be doing it. You, Frankie Edgar, what's your thoughts on that?
You know what? I come from a wrestling background. Jersey's a big wrestling state, and you know what? We got big hearts. You know, in Jersey, you know, we're tough guys, tough kids. You know, I've come up, you know, I've had a tough life coming up, and you know what? Just went out there with the mindset to give it everything I had the whole time, and it worked out in my favor, and you know, it's a blessing, and I feel good about it.
What was the difference to you in fighting guys from the UFC, and was it a tremendous jump in talent pool, or what's the story?
Yeah, you know what, it was definitely a big step up, you know, going from the smaller pro shows to the UFC. The UFC is the best show in the world, and I feel that I belong at that stage, and I just go out there with the mindset to give it 150% with everything I got, and a never say die attitude, and just push forward, and every fight that I have, I make it my fight, and I'm doing, you know, it's working out real well.
You hooked up with Joe Palooka Comics. I grew up with Joe Palooka, man. He was my hero as a kid, you know, growing up. How do you feel about this, and what do you think about the Joe Palooka Comic MMA?
Yeah, no, definitely. It's brand new. You know, they're rising up, and you know what? They've took a liking to me, and they've been behind me 100% for this fight. And, you know, we're a good team. You know, they're going to go up, and I'm going to go up, and we're going to go up together. And, you know, definitely check out the comic, and it's going to be good. You know, with MMA guys, it's getting bigger and bigger. The sport's evolving, and it's getting better.
What fighters do you think would be great comic book characters?
Oh, man, probably, I don't know any in particular, but probably, you know, there's a lot of good ones out there. You know, Rampage and Tito, and definitely probably see those guys up in there.
Who would be the most evil comic book character?
I don't know.
Would it be Brock?
Either Brock or Chael Sonnen, probably. One of those guys are going to probably take the icing on that.
Do you have any aspirations being one of the comic book characters?
Yeah, no, I hope so. Whatever they decide to do, you know, they're behind me 100%. I hope I get a crack to be up in there.
And how'd you get hooked up with Joe Palooka Comics? How'd that begin?
You know what? My manager handles a lot of my stuff when it comes to that. You know, my job is just to train and get right in there to fight and do battle. But, yeah, no, you know, I'm not really, you know, too particular of how we got hooked up that way. But I guess we took a liking to each other, and, you know, here we are now.
What does the future hold for you right now?
You know what, so the sky's the limit. As long as I put in 150% with everything I got, and just hoping for my going fight by fight. You know, not looking too far ahead, not worrying about the past, not worrying about the future, staying in the present day and living today for today and just going forward.
Cool, brother. Yeah, if you weren't fighting, what would you be doing?
Well, I'm actually a head wrestling coach at Burton Community College, and I own my own MMA and Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu school, so I'd definitely be probably coaching.
Train with any of the wrestlers like Pellegrino or Frankie Edgar, you know, when you were, you know, before you got into MMA?
Pellegrino's a lot older than me, but Frankie's only 1 year older than me, so we did a lot. We wrestled a two-time state champion and a college national champ. And, you know, yeah, through the national tour and stuff like that, you know, we wrestled alongside of each other. He was a little guy, I was a big guy, so we never got to actually wrestle with each other, but, you know, he's a great guy, tough kid. And, man, I don't see anybody taking him out for a while.
You beat a great guy in, you know, in your UFC fight, Steve Cantwell, former WBC champ. Besides your fight, what was the highlight fight of that night? I'm sure you saw all of them.
I'd have to say Frankie Edgar by far. To being a Jersey guy and also having, you know, knowing him and being, you know, having him on a personal level, is a great kid, great guy. And he worked so hard. And just to see see another Jersey guy prevail fashion that he did, and to knock out Maynard was great.
Unbelievable, because Maynard's never been knocked out, never been beaten.
No.
And they say Frankie doesn't finish fights, but almost everyone he's fought are guys that can't be finished.
Yeah.
Anything you want to tell the fans out there?
Hey, man, you know, never judge a book by its cover. Anything can happen. That's the beauty of the sport. You know what, just because your record has, you never submitted somebody or knocked them out, and you're fist fighting out there. Anything can happen. Always keep your hands up and guard up, and, you know, go out there with the intention for, you know, bad intentions.
I'm Bruce Kivo from MMA Confidential, and that's Mike Massenzio. Thank you, brother.